Assalamu alaikum. We start the program. Before starting the program, let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Alamzeb Amir. I am assistant professor in Department of Management Sciences, Fatah University. Before starting the program, I will request Qari Momin to come for recitation of Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس صدق الله العظيم.
Thank you, Qari Momin. Fatah University, the classes in Fatah University started in 2016. Currently, we have 7 departments in Fatah University. This is the first ever public sector university in Fatah region. The current vice chancellor of this university is Dr. Johor Ali. Before going to proceed, I will introduce the guest speaker of this session. Our guest speaker of today's session is Dr. Sanaullah Abbasi. He is the Inspector General of Police, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Dr. Sanaullah Abbasi has the PhD in anti-terrorism law. Also, he has a qualification in MS Social Sciences, MA Criminology, LLM Criminology, LLB. He is a writer of a book that title is Car Lifting Crimes. The thesis that he has done is that terrorism and remedies, honor killing, violence on women, bubble economy of Pakistan, and tax GDP ratio in Pakistan. Currently, he is serving as the Inspector General Police, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, from March 2020 till date. He has also served from 2013 as a DIG Special Branch Karachi. From 2013-2014, he also served as a DIG Hyderabad 2014-2015, additional IGP CTD Karachi from 15-6-2015 till 2018. Inspector General of Police 2018 till 2020, and now as an Inspector General of Police, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, from March 2020. We welcome you, sir, to this session. We also thanks to the honorable guest, the Regional Police Officer, Tayyib Hafiz Chima Saab, and District Police Officer, Javed Iqbal Saab. Before going to proceed the session, I will request the concerned person to share a video of this event. Now I invite the guest speaker of the session, Inspector General Police Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Dr. Sanaullah Abbasi, to address the students and faculty of Fatah University.
Thank you very much. I am very grateful to the faculty, VC, and my own colleagues, police officers, and dear students. Assalamu alaikum. Basically, I am very thankful to you people because this is a very important topic which we have to discuss today. It will not be my monologue lecture to you people, but it will be some sort of an interaction or discussion or a debate between the you people and me and even those police officers who are sitting there. Because whenever we are posted, we want to outreach to the youth. In Pakistan, approximately population consists of 70% of the youth. So that's why we have to engage the new generation, particularly the university students, because they have a very fertile mind. Issues should be discussed with them, debated with them. There may be new ideas, new innovations. They can be shared with us also, and we will be educated and guided by you people even. So these interactions will be very fruitful even in future. Now we discuss the main issue, the current issue a very important issue of this merger of the ex-Fatah into the mainland of Pakistan. And now what we are doing and what is the next in future, because it relates to the population of that area, the future of that area and the future of the people of that area. So it's very near and dear to us. As you know, this part of the region, it was a buffer region between the two countries, Afghanistan and Pakistan, inhabited by the tribal people on either side of the Durand line. They have their own conventions, traditions. Some traditions are very good, some traditions were bad. So finally, this space, this region was loosely controlled from centuries, and from 47 when it became a part of Pakistan, it was loosely governed, loosely by the stakeholders. Though this grey area that was created in this region, it was occupied by the non-stakeholders, which you have seen and everybody has seen in the more ferociously in the recent past, culminated into the full-fledged terrorism. With the grace of God and with the cooperation of the people, you people, your elders, the menace of terrorism has been contained to the larger extent. It has been eliminated in some way. So the sacrifices of you people and your elders are a part of an history. After that, this state of Pakistan, it's decided to merge this part of the land into the mainland of the Pakistan. Known to be a merger. What do you mean by this merger? One-liner, I will call it a one-liner interpretation of this merger. Merger, to me, our understanding, it's an extension of fundamental rights or human rights to you people, particularly to the new generation. Since centuries, it was denied to Jew people. Fundamental rights were not given to you people. What do you mean by fundamental rights? Fundamental rights means right of an dignity, right of education, right of a reputation, every right, right of free speech. These rights, though subjected to law, but these rights were given to you by this merger. How these rights are being implemented, or how they are will be implemented? They are implemented through two tools of state. Number one tool is the police, and number two is the judiciary. The police has been extended into these areas, and judiciary has also been extended to these areas. Previously, this region was regulated or policed rather in a very loose context by the levies and khasadars, loosely trained, loosely recruited people, loosely involved in the governance. So with this merger, these people were absorbed into regular police. The state has two options. Number one was the do away with these people being in a dead wood. And the second option was the this absorption of levies and kasadar into the regular police. The state has opted for the this absorption, avoiding the dashing away of these people, because it may have created the sense of deprivation. So first it was an absorption, then there comes the training, this schedule. because these were loosely recruited, loosely trained people, so they need a more training to be a regular part of the police. So we have conducted the approximately there are 29,000 people. These has been absorbed into the regular police, and regular police law has been extended to these areas, and judiciary has been also extended in these areas. I will later on explore the discussion on the role of judiciary, but to start with, I will start this policing of this area. Number one was the absorption. Number two was the training of these people. We have started the training. The 5,000 people are being trained by us, and 4,000 people are being trained by the army in the entire this region. It is in a phased program. Approximately in 2 years, this training program will be completed. And the third was the it was the physical part. Then we are also conducting the academic part of the training in our School of Investigation and other schools, because the training has two parts. Number one part is this physical part. Number second is an academic part, that is investigating part. Because when there is a policing, there is an investigation. When there is an investigation, then these cases will be brought into the court, and they will court will finally adjudicate and finally give a verdict or decision in favor or against anybody. Then comes we are conducting a recruitment in these areas. When the new blood will come to the police, then you will see the new face of this whole region. Because the previously recruited people, that ex-levies and khasadars, some people are illiterate, some people are very old people. So it was a match and a mix. So when we will make this new recruitment, inducting a new blood and youth into the police department in these areas, then you will see the new face of this region. Then we are extending the counter-terrorism department also into these areas. And we are also extending the special branch into these areas. And we are now even considering of introduction of this highway policing in these areas. So extension of these three specialized units will increase the policing. Increase this security paradigm. One thing is very important, that previously we were living in a security paradigm. Now we will live in a development paradigm. We are shifting from security paradigm to the development paradigm, to the human rights paradigm. So these human development, material development, so these are the development projects we are undertaking in the next phase of this phase-wise merger. Then I will dilate upon the extension of judiciary into these areas. Extension of judiciary means, to my understanding, the first priority will be the adjudication of the cases. Police will arrest the accused. Then there will be an investigation. These investigation will be brought to the courts. Courts will give the judgments. This is the one part. The second part, which is highly important, which is very important to you people, we people, and to the overall governance issues, that a restoration or enforcement of fundamental rights by the judiciary. What does it mean? It means that when any government functionary is not functioning, you have a right to have a recourse to the judiciary. You can have a recourse to the high courts, and even a Supreme Court, that so and so functionary is not performing well, police is not performing well, so and so department is not performing well, you have a recourse to the judicial forums, and judicial forums issue an order that lawfully legitimate rights should be enforced at any cost. It may be in education, it may be in development, it may be everything under the sun, under the constitution. So this is the biggest right which has been bestowed upon you people, and you have a right to recourse to the judiciary. So this is the biggest right. I will call it a new liberation to you people. You are liberated from the malaks, invested interest people, and those people who are depriving your rights, fundamental rights, or liberty, honor, dignity, and so many other rights. So you have this forum, irrespective of caste, color, or creed. So this is the biggest the right which has been given to you people. Finally, I will say that this development programs are being done, undertaken by the government, and we have extended the Police Act into these areas. The levies and ex-levies and fasadars, now the police, they have equal rights as that of police in Peshawar, Charsada, Mardan, Kohat, in all these regions. If any constable of these areas has equal rights, so by virtue of these rights, now we are extending this Police Act to these areas, and even of welfare projects of the police, which has been enforced into the settled areas, they are being extended to the police into the ex-Fata areas. So this is like some sort of a nutshell, my perspective of things, my narrative of things, and police perspective. So at the end, I am very thankful to you people that you have given me an opportunity to discuss and debate this issue in the future, because this merger is mainly for the younger generation. The old generation may have some reservations, may have some sensitivities because of the old benefits, old stakeholders, benefits accrued legitimately or illegitimately. But the whole focus is now on the younger generation. You will accrue the benefits, actual benefits of the this merger in future. This merger is mainly for you people. So that's why we are engaging you people. You are the future of Pakistan. You are truly a Pakistan. Tribal people, being a very loyal, very egalitarian, society-oriented people. So it will aid to the glory of Pakistan and beautification of Pakistan. Thank you very much.